name, amen. And so he says, he staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith. So now we see a different caliber of faith. Y'all see that? We see that he was, if he considered his body, his faith would have been made weak, entitled weak faith. Considering your body makes your faith weak. 7 days without prayer makes one weak.
Amen.
That's a long time.
Guess that. 7 days without prayer makes one weak. Yeah. 7 days without prayer makes one weak.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
And so now he's considering his body, his faith is made weak. But when he starts giving glory to God,
yes,
being fully persuaded on what he said, blocking out unbelief, blocking out doubt by giving God praise. That was his weapon. Praise is your weapon. Glory is your weapon. When doubt comes, thank God. When lack comes, you gotta catch that. Thank God. When it seems like it's impossible, like it just ain't gonna happen, thank God. Give God some glory. Don't let it move you. Don't let it stand you. Stay on course. Stay on course because you're getting ready to produce the promise. You're getting ready to obtain the promise. Oh, it's about to come. Oh, it's about to be manifested. Oh, come on. Hold hand in there. Just hold on to it.
Yes.
Hold on to it. Give God. When things seem like it just kind of got you discombobulated, you don't know what to do. When I was playing football and I forgot to play, the coach said, hit somebody. Just hit somebody. He says, when in doubt, fire out.
Amen.
Man, remember that. Hey, amen. Coach Goodlow, when you ain't got it right, at least hit somebody, then you're going to be okay. If you hit somebody, amen, praise God. Hey, you don't need to know exactly where the enemy is. Just stop giving God praise and let him guide the arrows to where he is. You don't need to know A to Z and A, B, and Pythagorean theorem, man. A plus B squared equals C squared. You don't need to know all of that. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hey, you don't need to know all of that. Just start giving God praise. He, remember when the Israelites was fighting? Maya, Oshinia, hallelujah. Remember when they was fighting? Hallelujah. And God began to send millstones from on high. My, he began to launch rocks out of heaven.
Fire.
Come on, man. Hallelujah. You see that weapons that God got, weapons of mass destruction that ain't nobody seen. Hey,
yeah.
Amen. Praise God. They was like, I killed that one and I seen you slay him, but who killed you over there?
Yeah.
I was like, I know me and you doubled up on him, but there's about four or five of us back. Who got this?
I think he's coming back with fire this time.
No, you better believe coming back with fire this time. He began to rock from heaven. Rocks begin to fall on the enemy. Begin to rock the enemy. You see what I'm saying? Because he knew, I mean, it was pinpoint too. It wasn't like, oops, let's try it again. Oops, we got his arm. No, we went to his head, but oops, we missed him. Might shoot it again. No, it was like pinpoint. Bam, it was over. Like, bam, 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 bam. It was over. It wasn't even no guess. He zeroed in on it. His sin attracted to, his sin caused him to have a bullseye on his life. That the judgment of God couldn't miss it because sin was the attracting factor that pulled it in. Ooh. Ooh, that's incredible, isn't it? How your own sin can attract the judgment and cause it to hit you right smack in the face. And it won't miss you. It won't miss you because your sin pulled it to you. If it was like a Geiger counter. Oh, there he is right there. And you can't get mad at nobody. Because if you don't do good, the Bible says sin lies at your door. Right there. When you open the door, if you don't do good, sin is right there. And sin pulls in judgment. Unless you recognize it and say, Lord, I'm sorry for what I did to you. And then mercy comes in and say, hey, judgment, you got to step aside because they asked God to forgive them. So now I got to come in and fix it. So mercy comes in, amen, when you should have been done. Mercy comes in and gives you a little space to recuperate from what you just did. and doesn't make the impact hard like it should be. So you might feel the vibrations of judgment hitting you, but mercy covers you so it didn't take you out. Oh, y'all.